In this video, I'm going to be doing a quick demonstration of the Skulpt Chisel fat measuring device. Okay, so here is the box. Okay, and it says here that you can measure muscle quality and you can measure your body fat percentage. And I've read that it's meant to be within 1 or 2 percentage points of a DEXA scan, which is meant to be quite an accurate way of measuring your body fat. And upon analyzing that data, it's meant to give you some personalized workout and nutrition advice via the app. So here is the device itself. So this is just the box. Here is the device itself. Okay, so it's just a little plastic box thing with like electrodes at the back. This is where you charge the device. You just dock it on this thing here, on this little dock, and then it comes with a USB cable that you just plug into a whatever plug adapter you have, mobile phone charger or something like that. So this, unlike the other Skulpt model, does not have a screen. So everything that you do with this device is via your app on your phone. So what else comes with it? It also comes with this little spray bottle thing here. And what you're meant to do is you're meant to spray the electrodes at the back before you analyze your muscles and body fat. So just like this. Like that, before every measurement. So now I'm going to switch over and give you a demonstration of how it operates and then give you a quick verdict on what I think about this Skulpt Chisel device. So I'm back now and I just want to talk about this Skulpt Chisel device here and what I think of it. So I bought this device because I wanted to get, I would say, a more accurate representation of what's going on in my body, what is my body fat percentage, so I can calculate my lean muscle mass and, you know, tailor my diet according to my needs. So I heard that this device was meant to be probably one of the most accurate devices out there that the consumer, the home consumer, can buy without going to pay a lot of money for a DEXA scan or underwater weighing and other alternative methods. So I watched a few YouTube videos and reviews of from other people, and it seemed to be quite a good device, legitimate device. And I noticed that most of the people that were getting good results were in good shape, as you know, when I say good shape, I mean advanced shape as it was. Okay, so like 10% body fat ish or below, actually. And they were getting accurate or within 1 or 2% of what the DEXA scan showed them. Now, I have had very different results with this device, and it's not just me, I've also tested this on my other half as well, my girlfriend. And basically we have come to the conclusion that it's a little bit inconsistent. So you can do a test and then 2-3 minutes later, you'll repeat the same test on the same muscle groups and then you'll get a different result. And when I say different result, I mean like by 1 or 2%. So for example, if you did a test and it said you're 25%, 5 minutes later, it might say you're 26.5% or 27%. So I've tested and tested and tested this, and I've tried different methods and tried different locations, and I keep getting the same results. So I feel like I can't get the best out of this device. Personally, I think maybe it's geared more towards the advanced athlete rather than just, you know, the regular Joe blogs. But let me go through how it works anyway. So what you do is you press this button here on the side You just hold it and then it starts up. What you then do is you get the app on your phone and you sign up and do all that stuff. And then it tells you to take a quick scan if you want to know your body fat percentage. So what you'll do is you'll just press the quick scan button here. And then it will begin by, if you can see that, it will begin by telling you to place the device on your right tricep. And then after that, it will go on to your right abdominal section and then your right quadricep muscle in your leg. And each time you do it, you spray the back of this. So I'm just going to give you an example now of how it would work. So just spray this a few times, and then what you do is you put it under your arm like this. You should see it's gonna go green now, which means it's measuring. See, now it actually didn't work, so let me try again. Let's just spray it again. It should start going green now, and it should get a result. Yeah, that means it's got a result when it goes blue. Yeah, there you go. So I took a measurement about 24 minutes ago. And 24 minutes ago, my muscle quality was 18.1. And now it's 20.3. So I don't really know what's going on. And then an hour ago, it was 18.8. So it's on a scale from 0 to 100. Okay. And like 25 or something means like you're fair, and below 25 means you need work. So I need work, basically. Yeah, so I'm looking at the data here, and if you can just see there, the variation in the results, it's up and down, it's pretty much everywhere. So I'm trying to figure out what it actually means. And yeah, I can't really understand what it means. I've been on a diet recently as well, and I've lost weight. I did a scan earlier on, and it says on this, when I measured all my muscle groups, it combines all the data together and it figures out, okay, you must be this. So on average, I've lost about 4 or 5% body fat from my arm, my abdominal and my right quadricep. But when I actually looked at the data, when it combines all the data together, it says last month I was 36.2%, and this month, despite losing weight and despite losing body fat percentage from my different muscle areas, apparently I've increased in body fat. So none of the information to me really makes sense. Like you can see here, look, June the 25th, 36.2. Since then I've been dieting, I've lost weight, and I tested my muscle fat as well today, and all of them went down, yet my body fat percentage went up. Really haven't got a clue, to be honest, how that works. I did another test about 20 minutes later, and then my body fat went down to 35.7. So to cut a long story short, I'm not going to be keeping this device. I'm going to be sending it back because I just think the results are too varied to draw any conclusion from. What I've had more success with is the traditional, I think they call it the Navy body fat test. So all you do is you get a measuring tape, you measure your waist at the navel for men, you measure your neck as well, you input your height and you input your body mass as well, your weight. And it combines all those things together, puts it into a formula, and the numbers that I've got out of that is pretty much in line with this, to be honest with you. It's about 34, whereas this says 35. So yeah, it's it's, I mean, if that's doing it for free with a, or with a measuring tape that cost me £1, then I'm just going to do that. And it's more reliable as well, because your measurements, they don't change minute to minute. So that's all I'd like to say about that. I think with the comprehensive plan that they say that they're going to give you based on your level and stuff, I've looked at it here. It gives you a few short sentences. See, for me, it said, no significant muscle imbalances have been detected. Please continue to measure all your muscles regularly. That's what it says to me. Was there anything else? Targeted training. So it reckons my weak areas are my shoulders, my biceps, and my calves. So can you see there? Shoulders, biceps, and calves. When you click it, so I'm clicking shoulders, it's recommending me these exercises. So basically it's just giving you a load of different shoulder exercises. So barbell front raise, upright barbell row, shoulder press, whatever, in a long list. And then if you go to your other weak areas like calves, it's saying dumbbell calf raise, standing calf raise, some other weird ones as well, balance board. So yeah, as far as I'm concerned, that doesn't really sell it to me, because most people can look that stuff up anyway. It seems very like more like formulaic, you know, copy and paste. It knows that I've got a few weaknesses in areas where it thinks it does, and it's just copied and pasted some default exercises. So the device itself was £100, so it's not cheap. I think I'm just going to stick to doing it by the old-fashioned way, measuring tape and the scales, and see what that says. And then you can input that data into the Navy Bodyfat measuring formula, and it will calculate a rough figure about what you are. So yeah, that's what I'm going to say about this review. That's how I'm going to review this thing. I'm going to send it back to Amazon on the grounds that it didn't really work. So any questions about the device, just let me know, and I'll be happy to help you. If you can subscribe to this channel, that would really help me. This is a new YouTube channel, so I need all the help I can get at the moment. But yeah, thanks for watching the video, and I'll see you next time.